بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. بعد أن اتفقنا على شروط حضور هذه الدورة، أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يوفق الجميع لما أحب ويرضى، نذكر ما يتعلق بدراسة هذا المتن قبل الدراسة. نعم.
So in the name of Allah, the most merciful, the bestower of mercy, give all praise to Allah, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon His messenger. And after we've agreed on these conditions, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He guides every single one of us to everything which He loves and He's pleased with, then we'd like to mention some things that relate to this lesson.
لو قال لك قائل لماذا اخترنا دراسة هذا المتن أي متن نواقض الإسلام في هذه الليلة؟ لماذا ندرس النواقض؟ لماذا ندرس نواقض الإسلام؟ ما السبب؟
نعم. So if a person comes to you and he says that why have we chosen to study this text, Nawaqid al-Islam, the matters which invalidate al-Islam in this evening? Why have we chosen to study those matters which invalidate a person's Islam? What's the reason behind which we should study this text or these things, these matters which invalidate a person's Islam?
الإجابة الله أعلم تكون.
And the answer, and Allah knows best, is
لأننا طلاب.
Number one, because we are students.
والطالب لابد أن يرجع إلى العلماء الربانيين في دراسة المتون العلمية.
And the student of knowledge has to refer back to the scholars, the علماء الربانيين, meaning those older senior scholars who have knowledge and they act upon their knowledge. The student of knowledge has to go back to those type of scholars in terms of studying and studying the Tawheed.
ونصح العلماء رحمهم الله تعالى بدراسة هذا المتن أي متن نواقض الإسلام.
And the scholars, they themselves have advised with the studying of this text, نواقض الإسلام.
ثم أهم من هذا أننا ندرس النواقض حتى لا نأتي بناقض من نواقض الإسلام ويكون بهذا نسأل الله السلام العافية الخروج من الإسلام إلى الكفر.
And more important than this, the reason why we study this text, Nawaqid al-Islam, the matters which invalidate a person's Islam, so that we don't end up doing an action which invalidates and annuls our religion, our Islam. And therefore, and we ask Allah's safety and His pardoning, we leave Islam and we enter into disbelief.
وكذلك حتى نحذر الآخرين من الوقوع في هذه النواقض.
And also, we also study this text, or we also study the matters which invalidate a person's Islam, so we can warn other people so that they don't fall into one of these matters.
هذا هو السؤال الأول قبل الدراسة. لماذا اخترنا دراسة هذا المتن المبارك؟
So this is the first question before we start studying this blessed text. Why have we chosen to study this text or this subject?
نصيحة العلماء.
Number one, because it's the advice of the scholars.
حتى لا نقع في هذه النواقض.
So that we don't fall into one of these matters which invalidate a person's Islam.
حتى نحذر منها.
And that we can warn other people from them.
السؤال الثاني.
The second question.
قبل البدء في الدراسة.
This is before we begin actually studying the text.
ما معنى النواقض؟
What is the meaning of النواقض؟
ما معنى نواقض الإسلام؟
What is the meaning of نواقض الإسلام؟
نواقض الإسلام، النواقض أو المبطلات أو المفسدات أو ما يخرج نسأل الله السلام العافية من الإسلام إلى الكفر وينقض أي يخرج الإنسان من الإسلام إلى الكفر نسأل الله السلام العافية. نعم.
So نواقض الإسلام or the term نواقض, it means anything which invalidates, anything which يفسد, which corrupts, anything which takes a person, and we ask Allah's safety and His pardoning, away from Islam and enters him into kufr, disbelief.
إذن تسمى النواقض ويصح أن تسمى المفسدات أو المبطلات.
So we can say, we can call these matters نواقض, matters which invalidate. We can also call them مبطلات, again something which falsifies something. We can also call them مفسدات, something which corrupts, a matter which corrupts something.
نعم. هذا هو السؤال الثاني. لماذا ما معنى النواقض؟
So this is the second question. What is the meaning of نواقض؟
السؤال الثالث قبل الدراسة.
The third question before we begin studying.
قال في عنوان هذا المتن المبارك نواقض الإسلام العشرة. هل النواقض محصورة في هذه النواقض العشرة أو غير محصورة أي يزاد على هذه العشرة.
The author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he said in the title of this blessed text, نواقض الإسلام العشرة, the 10 matters which invalidate a person's Islam. So therefore the question is that are the matters which invalidate a person's Islam limited to 10, or are there more matters other than these 10 which invalidate a person's Islam?
الجواب والله أعلم أنها غير محصورة بهذا العدد بل هي أكثر من 10 نواقض.
And the answer is, and Allah knows best, that those matters which invalidate a person's Islam are not limited to this number 10. Rather, they are more than the 10 that have been mentioned.
وهذا سيتضح بإذن الله تعالى من كلام المؤلف في آخر هذه النواقض.
And this matter will become clear when we come to the speech of the author towards the end of this text.
طيب لماذا يقول الإمام رحمه الله تعالى أن نواقض الإسلام عشرة ثم في نهاية النواقض يقول أنها تزيد عن العشرة على ما سيأتي معنا من كلام المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى. لماذا يقول في أول الرسالة أنها عشرة ثم بعد هذا يقول أنها من أعظم النواقض؟ يعني هناك في ما يقع فيه الناس أكثر من هذه العشر. نعم.
So the question is that why does the author therefore at the beginning say that the matters which invalidate Islam are 10 and yet the Imam rahimahullah towards the end of the text he says that they're more than 10. So at the end of the text the Imam, may Allah have mercy upon him, he said that these matters which invalidate a person's Islam are from the greatest of matters, meaning that there are other matters which invalidate a person's Islam that people often fall into. So therefore, why did the Imam mention at the beginning of the text that there are only 10?
سار المؤلف الله أعلم بهذه الطريقة بذكر أن نواقض الإسلام عشرة وهي غير محصورة في عشرة على طريقة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So the methodology of the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, in saying that the matters which invalidate a person's Islam are 10, even though they're more than 10, he has traversed the methodology of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
نعم وحتى تحفظ هذه النواقض العشرة وكذلك نحذر منها.
And so that you can memorize 10 of these matters which invalidate a person's Islam, and that you can warn other people or be careful of falling into these matters, these 10 matters.
مثال هذا في سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
An example of this from the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قال عليه الصلاة والسلام اجتنبوا السبع الموبقات.
That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, be careful or avoid 7 destructive sins.
هل الموبقات سبع فقط؟
Are the destructive sins only 7?
لا.
No.
بل الموبقات أكثر من 7 لكن أراد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من الصحابة رضوان الله عليهم أن يحفظوا في هذا المجلس 7 موبقات حتى إذا خرجوا من عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم استطاعوا أن يتذكروا هذه 7 وهذا من حسن تعليم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So are the destructive sins only 7? No, they're more than 7. However, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he wanted from the companions that they should memorize 7 destructive sins and so they can be aware of them and warn other people from them. And this is from the good ways that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to educate the Sahaba, the companions.
نعم ومثل هذا أيضا.
And another example of this is
خمس من الفطرة.
That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that there are 5 matters are from the fitra.
مع أن سنن الفطرة أكثر من هذا على ما وجد في سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Even though the sunan, the recommended acts of the fitra or more than 5, as has been mentioned in the narrations of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
وكذلك في العشر المبشرين من الجنة.
And that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that there are 10 people who were given the glad tidings of entering into paradise.
لأن هناك من بشرهم النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام بالجنة غير هؤلاء العشر.
And yet there are other people that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave the glad tidings of paradise other than these 10.
إذا ذكر العدد في نصوص الكتاب والسنة.
If a number is mentioned in the text of the Quran and the Sunnah,
لا أحد يتكلم.
Nobody speak, please.
نعم. إذا ذكر العدد في نصوص الكتاب والسنة.
If a number is mentioned in the Quran and Sunnah, in the text of the Quran and the Sunnah,
هل هذا العدد يكون له مفهوم أو ليس له مفهوم؟ هل يحدد بهذا العدد أو يزاد عليه على ما ذكرنا في السبع الموبقات والعشر بشر بالجنة وخمس من الفطرة؟
So if a particular number has been mentioned in the text of the Quran and the Sunnah, does that mean that we can't increase on this limit? Does this limit have an understanding in the Quran and the Sunnah? As we mentioned, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned seven destructive sins and five matters of the fitrah.
مرة أخرى.
So one more time.
إذا ذكر العدد في نصوص الكتاب والسنة.
If a particular number is mentioned in the text of the Quran and the Sunnah.
هل يكون هذا العدد له مفهوم أي محدد بهذا العدد أو يزاد عليه؟
Does this mean that that number that was mentioned, that the matter is limited to that number, or can there be more than the number that was mentioned?
الجواب ننظر في نصوص الكتاب والسنة. إذا وجدنا ما يزيد على هذا العدد صار العدد ليس له مفهوم أي غير محدد.
The answer to this is that we look into the text of the Quran and the Sunnah. So if we see in the Quran and the Sunnah that there are other matters that have been mentioned, and therefore we can say that these matters are not limited to the number that was mentioned, and therefore we can increase on it. If, however, we don't find any additions to this number, then we can say that this matter is limited to the number that was mentioned in the Quran or the Sunnah.
كما قلنا في السبع الموبقات لأن وجدنا في الكتاب والسنة ما يزيد على هذه الموبقات وفي خمس من الفطرة وفي العشر مبشر بالجنة.
Like we said regarding the seven destructive sins, that when we look into the Quran and the Sunnah, we find other sins that are more than seven. And we said about the five recommended acts of fitra. And yet we find the Quran and Sunnah other recommended acts of the fitra. And like we said regarding the 10 people who were given the glad tidings of paradise. And yet we find the Quran and the Sunnah other people more than these 10 who were given the glad tidings of paradise.
وإن لم نجد في نصوص الكتاب والسنة ما يزيد على هذا العدد المذكور يكون العدد هذا له مفهوم أي لا يزاد عليه كما في أركان الإسلام والإيمان وأبواب الجنة مثلا نسأل الله من فضله نعم.
However, if we look into the Quran and Sunnah and we don't find any extra matters than the number that has been given, then we can say that these matters are limited to that number. So for example, if we look at the pillars of Islam, five, and we don't find in the Quran and Sunnah more pillars, so we say that this is limited to five. If we look at the pillars of Iman, either they're six. So therefore we can't say, we don't find the Quran and Sunnah more pillars to this six. And also, if we look at the text of the Quran and Sunnah at the doors of paradise, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from His virtue that He gives us the doors of paradise.
لو قال قائل,
if a person said,
لماذا يذكر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم العدد وهو ليس له مفهوم أي يزاد عليه كما في السبع الموبقات وفي العشر المبشرين بالجنة ولماذا لم يقل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم اجتنبوا الموبقات ومنها كذا وكذا وكذا.
So if a person says that if these numbers don't have a meaning, if these numbers don't have a limit, then why did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mention that number? For example, why did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mention seven destructive sins and yet there's more destructive sins than seven? Why did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mention the limit of the recommended acts of the fitrah, i.e. five, or the 10 people who are given the glad tidings of paradise, and yet there are more? Why didn't the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam just say, avoid the destructive sins, and from amongst them are X, Y, Z?
نقول,
we say,
أن هذا من حسن تعليم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
That this is from the good ways of the education of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
أراد من الصحابة رضي الله عليهم أن يحفظوا في هذا المجلس سبع موبقات.
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he wanted from the companions to memorize in that sitting seven destructive sins.
وفي المجلس الآخر العشر المبشرين بالجنة.
And in another sitting, the 10 people who were given the glad tidings of paradise.
حتى إذا خرج الصحابة رضي الله عليهم من مجلس النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام استطاعوا أن يستحضروا هذه السبع وكذلك العشر المبشرين وغير هذا وهذا ذكرناه أنه من حسن التعليم عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So that when the companions, may Allah be pleased with them, when they leave the gathering of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, they've memorized and they're able to recall 7 destructive sins. Or the 10 people who give them the glad tidings of paradise. So as we mentioned, this was an example of the good education of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
السؤال الأخير والله أعلم قبل الدراسة.
And the last question, and Allah knows best before beginning studying of the text.
هل يمكن أن نلخص هذه النواقض؟
Is it possible for us to summarize these matters which invalidate a person's Islam?
نعم والله أعلم نستطيع أن نلخص هذه النواقض وغيرها من نواقض الإسلام في أن النواقض تجتمع في أمور 4.
And he said that yes, we are able to summarize all of the matters which invalidate a person's Islam. And that is by saying that every matter which invalidates a person's Islam must contain 4 matters, or must fulfill 4 things, 4 matters.
قول,
a statement,
وعمل,
an action,
واعتقاد,
a belief,
وشك,
and a doubt.
قول,
so a statement,
وعمل,
an action,
واعتقاد,
a belief,
وشك,
and a doubt.
قول,
an action,
كسب على ما سيأتي معنا, سب الرب أو الاستهزاء بالدين.
So a statement like somebody insulting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or somebody insulting the religion.
عمل,
an action,
السحر مثلا,
like for example magic.
الاعتقاد,
a belief,
كأن يعتقد أن غير هدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أفضل من هدي عليه الصلاة والسلام على ما سيأتي معنا.
An example of a person who believes, he believes in his heart that the guidance of somebody other than the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is better than the guidance of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. A belief.
أو الشك.
And then a doubt.
كأن يشك في كفر كل من بلغته دعوة النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام على ما سيأتي بإذن الله.
And then finally, or the fourth matter is a doubt. Like for example, if somebody has a doubt regarding the disbelief of those people to whom the message of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to, and they didn't accept it or they rejected it.
نراجع هذه الأمور ثم نبدأ بالدرس إن شاء الله تعالى.
So let's revise these matters that we've just covered, and then we start with the lesson.
من يذكر لي هذه الأسئلة التي ذكرناها قبل الدراسة؟
So who can mention for me the questions that we've just mentioned? Before we start the lesson.
السؤال الأول.
What's the first question?
نعم. من يعرف?
Who knows?
اتفقنا على أن نتذاكر فيما بيننا.
We agreed that all of us will revise and memorize with each other.
أنا والله أعلم لست بعالم. أنا طالب علم وأتيت إليكم حتى نتذاكر العلم فيما بيننا ونذكر ما ذكر العلماء رحمهم الله تعالى.
He said that I'm not a scholar. I'm just a student of knowledge who has come to you so that we can all revise with each other that which Allah has mentioned.
نعم. السؤال الأول.
The first question.
What are the نواقض? What does the نواقض mean?
ما معنى
لا.
النواقض?
No. قبل هذا.
Before this.
أصبر أصبر. الذي يعرف يرفع أصبع.
The one who knows, raise your hand.
نعم. فلما حضروه قالوا أنصتوا أي الجن. فلا بد أن نتأدب في مجالس العلماء. وفي مجالس طلب العلم من أراد أن يتكلم يرفع إصبعه أذن له تكلم.
Like Allah mentioned regarding the jinn, that when the jinn came to the gathering, they became silent. So therefore we have to maintain the manners when it comes to seeking knowledge. So the one who knows, raise your hand, and when you've been given permission, then you can answer.
من يعرف السؤال الأول?
Who knows the first question?
نعم.
لماذا اخترت الكتاب نواقض الإسلام?
أوقف. Stand up. نعم. لماذا اخترنا دراسة هذا المتن المبارك؟ فتح الله عليك.
آمين.
قل آمين. نعم. Wait. نعم.
So as the brother Sajjad mentioned, that the first question we ask is why have we chosen this book or this text called نواقض الإسلام؟
لا
لا. وأنت قال. لماذا اخترنا دراسة هذا المتن؟ الإجابة تكون.
So why have we chosen this book to study? The answer is.
نصيحة العلماء.
That it is the advice of the scholars.
حتى لا نقع في ناقض من النواقض.
So we don't fall into a matter which invalidates a person's Islam.
ولأنه قد يقع الإنسان في ناقض وهو لا يدري عنه.
And that maybe a person will fall into something which invalidates a person's Islam and he doesn't know.
وحتى نحذر منها.
And so that we can warn the other people.
السؤال الثاني.
The second question. Stand up.
نعم نعم. السؤال الثاني
ما معنى
النواقض؟
What's the meaning of النواقض؟
النواقض تأتي بمعنى النواقض.
So النواقض can mean something which invalidates
أو المفسدات
or corrupts
أو المبطلات
or something which falsifies
أو ما يخرج من الإسلام نسأل الله السلام العافية إلى الكفر
or anything which takes a person out of Islam and into disbelief and we ask Allah for pardon and safety.
نعم السؤال الثالث
the third question
السؤال الثالث
the third question
نعم لابد نعم
النواقض هل هي محصورة على العشر
الله يفتح عليك فتح الله عليك هل النواقض محصورة في هذه النواقض العشرة أو هي أكثر من عشر نواقض
So the answer is as the brother mentioned may Allah bless him that these matters which invalidate a person's Islam are they limited to 10 or they limited to 10 or can they be more than 10
ذكرنا والله أعلم أنها غير محصورة بعشرة نواقض
and we mentioned and Allah knows best that the matters which invalidate a person's Islam are more than 10 they're not limited to 10
ولهذا أشار المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى في نهاية هذه النواقض
and for this reason the author he pointed towards this towards the end of his text
وجدنا في نصوص الكتاب والسنة ما يزيد على هذه النواقض
and we have also found in the text of the Quran the Sunnah more than 10 matters which invalidate a person's Islam
إذن لماذا قال نواقض الإسلام العشرة وهي غير محصورة في عشرة
so therefore the next question is why did the author mention or why did he limit it to 10 and yet there are more than 10 matters which invalidate a person's Islam
من يعرف
who knows
نعم
so we remember which ones
حتى نحفظ
طيب لأن هذه هي طريقة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وكان عليه الصلاة والسلام يذكر العدد أحيانا وليس له مفهوم حتى يحفظ الصحابة رضي الله عليهم ويحفظ من بعدهم
so good so that we can remember the number of matters which invalidate a person in Islam and also that this is the way of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that sometimes he would mention a number even though those matters aren't limited to that number and this was so that the companions could memorize and remember and recall this
هل العدد إذا ذكر في نصوص الكتاب والسنة يكون له مفهوم أو ليس له مفهوم أي يحدد بهذا العدد الذي ذكر أو يزاد عليه
so the next question is that if a particular number is mentioned then does that mean that those matters are limited to that number in the Quran and the Sunnah
نعم
There's more. If it's in the Quran a certain time, then that's it. But if it's not, then there can be more than that number of.
فتح الله عليك. إذا وجدنا في نصوص الكتاب والسنة ما يزيد على هذا العدد صار العدد ليس مفهوم أو غير محدد. لأننا وجدنا ما يزيد عليه. وإن لم نجد صار العدد له مفهوم. ومثلنا على ما يزاد عليه بالسبع موبقات. وبالعشر المبشرين من الجنة وبالذي لا يزاد عليه أركان الإسلام والإيمان مثلا نعم
So as the brother mentioned may Allah bless him that if there's a number that has been mentioned and yet we find the Quran and the Sunnah more than that number then we say that that number which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned doesn't have an understanding in terms of a limit if however we look into the Quran and the Sunnah and we don't find any more matters more than the Prophet ﷺ stated, the number that he stated, then we say that it's limited to this. And we mentioned that the Prophet ﷺ gave a limit like the seven destructive sins and the 10 people who enter into Jannah who have got the glad tidings of being entered into Jannah and yet there are more people and there are more destructive sins than the number that the Prophet ﷺ mentioned. And we also mentioned that the Prophet ﷺ mentioned five pillars of Islam and we find the Quran and Sunnah no more addition to this so there are only five or the six pillars of Iman and in the Quran and the Sunnah we don't find more than these six pillars so therefore this number here it has a limit or an understanding to it
نعم بعد هذا سألنا هل يمكن حصر النواقض أي هذه النواقض العشرة وغيرها من النواقض أم لا
and then after this we asked that is it possible for us to summarize all of these matters which invalidate a person's Islam
من يعرف؟
Who knows؟
نعم. نعم. يمكن حصر هذه النواقض والله أعلم في ضوابط أربعة.
He said yes, as the brother mentioned, may Allah bless him. that yes, we can summarize all of the matters which invalidate a person's Islam in something which compromises of or includes four things.
Al-awwal, al-qawl.
Either a statement.
Al-thani, al-amal.
An action.
Al-thalith, al-i'tiqad.
Thirdly, a belief.
Al-rabi'.
And fourth,
al-shak.
Fourth, a doubt.
Na'am. طيب نترك لكم عشر دقائق تكتبوا فيها ما أخذنا ثم بعد هذا نراجع مرة ثانية أو ثالثة ثم نبدأ بالدرس الجديد.
Okay, so now we're going to leave you 5 or 10 minutes so you can sit together and revise and recall and write down whatever the Sheikh has said. And then we'll come back to this and we'll test you and we'll revise it 2 times or 3 times or however many times.
لكن على ما اتفقنا عليه.
But according to the conditions that we have all agreed upon.
لا يكون هناك شيء من أمور الدنيا في مسجد من مساجد الله سبحانه وتعالى.
That nothing should be said or spoken about which is from the world, from the affairs of the worldly life in the mosque, from the mosques of Allah.
فاجتمعوا الآن على المذاكرة والكتابة ثم بعد هذا نبدأ بعد 10 دقائق بإذن الله تعالى.
So, come together in your groups and revise and write down and memorize that which the Shaykh has said for 10 minutes and then we'll come back to this.
Wallahu a'lam wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa alihi.